Fellas, I think I'm gonna be out of a job. Some of the ludicrous approaches to canon I've seen in the last month, it's beyond parody. Forget forums, forget Twitter, let's head over to the Doctor Who fan wiki and see what they have to say about The Foretold. The Foretold returned inside the TARDIS in the webcast The Doctor Surprises Fans at the Doctor Who Experience, which was shot at the Doctor Who Experience, in which he proceeded to attack everyone. No explanation is given for why he is once again active despite his death at the end of his first meeting with the Doctor in Mummy on the Orient Express. He can, at any rate, now be seen by all the characters in the scene, with no countdown in sight, implying that the nature of his undeath has changed significantly. How do I meme that? It's already perfect. Alas, welcome back to the Matrix. I might be editing as a full-time job now, but you know I always got time for you babies. Sammy's OCD won't let him rest. Guess who went to time fracture? Weeping angels once killed a doctor and forced her to regenerate. This is Sandra. I am close friends with the Sandra Doctor. She said so. Of all the things I did whilst in the time fracture event, and trust me, I've got the paperwork, legal work to prove it, I am now canonically part of her fam. Consider this how you will. Canonically, that same doctor who we named, shared experiences with, loved and cherished. Well, you know, sometimes, I was kind of back and forth. This doctor sacrificed her life to save me and Erin, and some other very nice strangers dressed in Doctor Who cosplay, from a weeping angel attack. Although nobody's experience is the same, minor to major time fracture spoilers ahead. If you don't want anything revealed, feel free to bounce out of today's video early. I won't take it personally. A bomb dropped on 1945 England, opening up the time fracture, a conspiracy across all of time and space. An opened portal to everywhere and anywhere, with a very nefarious purpose behind it. So the second we're let loose, I go and talk to a unit scientist. She flashes me a look like I've just interrupted her from her actual work, which takes me and Erin back. I'm like, oh, we're properly in character. There's no nudge nudge wink wink about this. So we put our investigative skills to the test, and clearly I did something right because my name is called to go in the time fracture first. I'm given this unit document telling me that all of my rights as a British citizen are being signed away, and that if I leak anything about what I find in the time fracture, my family will be informed that I died in the Loch Ness.
There's a bar over there. We were saving the world.
It's a med bar.
Nah.
Med bar.
I saw alcohol. Sure.
So it's all very confidential. Which reminds me, I stumbled across the Black Archive on the way to the toilet. That was my favourite moment of the whole thing, because I came across that all by myself. A couple pictures will not do this room justice. A Dalek gun was there, The Moment was there, K9 was up there, and somehow they got their hands on handles, which I won't inquire about. Maybe he came through the time fracture. Daleks stormed the place. Me and Erin jumped to the right because we see the scrapyard in hopes that I can meet the famous pig man. I went in with a mission to hunt this swine down, just chase the actor through the experience. Right away, we get in with the Doctor. It took us a couple moments to realize who this was, but 13's experiencing some amnesia. She pulls out some cue cards and we pick out a name for her. This is why, I guess for us, she's the Sandra Doctor. All of time and space, what did we do first with the Doctor? Well, my first adventure as a companion was trying to get into her Kablam account. She lost her password because she forgot her name. After reciting some Das Kapital to the Kablam man, I find the pig. He's cockney, he's scary, he loves to sing his favourite song. He gets me to bang on a drum, I start an auction, which I think eventually led to him being killed. So there's some guilt. A Gallifreyan time agent appears and the Doctor starts fighting her, but I quickly lose interest, like I ditch my new fam. Because in the crowd, I spot Brian the Ood, who I then decide to follow for the rest of the experience. He's very polite. At one point in the bar, I asked if he can drink, all the while he was holding a gun behind his back. Eventually, he excuses himself, and in the middle of the bar has a big choreographed fight scene with Time Lady Woman. Sorry, Time Lord Victorious fans. He was pretty tight-lipped about the whole thing. My Brian didn't even seem to know who the Doctor was. His story path doesn't really go anywhere. He just has to pick up a package for the gun. But for some reason, it fell into the time fracture and ended up in 1890s Torchwood. So we head off into the past to find the planet of Wales, bump into William Shakespeare, and then there was another punch up in Torchwood. Eventually, and I am sorry to report this, Brian was murdered by Gallifreyan time agent lady. Right after the intermission, he's in this dirty, sore bathroom, and he's been shot dead with his blood everywhere. But he was also a companion. He was a legitimate companion to the Doctor. I wept that day. And it's at this point, in a dimly lit corridor of plastic window dummies, we're attacked by angels. And the Doctor says, "I'll hold them off. Run!" But then in the next section, who emerges out of the No More painting, but a Doctor who can only be said to resemble Joe Martin's The Fugitive. So, what's that about? An impromptu costume change? An emergency recasting? Motherfucker, that's what regenerations are! I was there when the 13th Doctor died. I could have done something. I didn't try that hard, of course. But yeah, confirmed. Jodie Whittaker regenerates into Joe Martin.
Know what happened, but I liked it.
Turns out it was all the Time Lords. The Time Lords did the time fracture? Shocker. It's a genocide plan to kill all life in the universe except Earth and Gallifrey in their greater plan to revive Rassilon. It's mad, right? I've got Aaron in one ear, doesn't know a thing about Doctor Who, chanting and cheering for Rassilon the Resurrected. He's brought back only to get immediately exterminated as Davros stages a two Dalek invasion of the High Council. Literally, some Daleks enter and then they piss right off again. How's that for a fact? Davros invaded Gallifrey with two Daleks. And all of the High Council died around us. Again, could have done more, but my heart wasn't really in it. If you want to find Davros in person during the performance, he's hiding just behind the gridlock-style drug van. He's got big plans. All in all, it's fantastic. You gotta get down there whilst it's still there. We don't know how temporary it will be, but now I can officially stamp my own name into the Doctor Who canon for a hefty price of £60. Worth it? Mate, it was worth it just for introducing Brian the Ood to William Shakespeare alone. I was the last person he spoke to. His final words were, "Excuse me," before I found him dead in a bathroom. Imagine if another Doctor Who companion got that treatment, just killed off screen in some immersive theatre thing.